the pump that Rocky French uses in transferring 3-day-old water inhabited by Golden Kuhol, no? Fed with Malunggay, into water tanks like this. Mm-hmm. Ano itong mga tanke na ito, Rocky?
This is just a holding tank to mature and age your ammonia. So there's a natural processes that happens here. And it takes about 6 to 8 weeks for your ammonia to break down into nitrites and then from nitrites into nitrates. So
okay, assuming, ako si farmer, simple lang ako, hindi ko nagsasabi ng intindi yung English, no? Assuming na nandito na yung aking ammonia for 6 weeks, what do I do to convert this into fertilizer which I could use for my plants?
Well, you just have to age them and wait for the time because it takes time for the organism to convert your ammonia.
6 to 8 weeks?
6 to 8 weeks.
Assuming na inabot na ako ng 8 weeks, anong indicator na pwede ko na siyang gamitin?
Yeah. When you get a water sample and your water turns into a wine color like this, you know you have nitrates already.
All right.
So what you do with your nitrates, you can either mix calcium hydroxide or magnesium hydroxide, which is your apog or your lime.
Okay.
And then what
ano
you
ang,
do...
Ano ang dilution? How many kilos of apog in, say...
Probably in 1 gallon, put 2 tablespoons of apog.
Okay.
And then you want to reduce the pH to 6.5 because once you introduce your lime, your pH shoots up and your plants don't want that. So what you do is you get one kalamansi.
And ipiga. Okay, ulitin mo natin yan. Okay, after 6 to 8 weeks, yan na yung nitrates ko, yan na yun, no?
There you go, yes.
And then, magamit ko yan as abono, kung hahaluan ko na ang apog.
Apog,
ang 1 kilo to?
No, 1 gallon.
1 gallon of ammonia.
Of your nitrates.
Of nitrates.
About 2 tablespoons of...
2 kutsarang apog.
Correct.
Okay. But since paglagay ko ng apog, tataas yung pH level... Okay. Kailangan ko siyang pigaan ng isang kalamansi.
Isang kalamansi o 2 tablespoons again of vinegar to
vinegar. Suka.
Bring it down to 6.5.
6.5 ang pH.
And from there, you could foliar spray it or you could deliver it as a fertilizer.
So, pwede ko nang right there, no?
Yes.
Ano ang dilution ko? Halimbawa, 1 gallon na ganun. Ilang...
When you start with small plant, they don't need that much. They'll probably need 100 ppm. So, what you do is We have a way of establishing how much nitrates we have per container. And what we do is we dilute that normally 5 to 6 times.
Okay. So, kung may 1 gallon ako na...
Dilute it 5 times with water.
So, 1 gallon na nitrates, 5 gallon na tubig.
Correct. Yes.
Yun ang spray ko pang foliar.
Yeah, pang foliar okay. Mo.
So, ito yung formula. And magagawa ito ni ordinary farmer.
Exactly.
Okay. So, ulitin ko lang. Rocky, pakibalik nyo dito. Balik ka. Return to sender. Dito ka muna. Para maintindihan kasi dahil mahirap minsan. Hindi nila maintindihan masyado. Pakiulit lang. Yung 1 gallon na ganito, na nitrates, okay, hahaluan ko ng 2 kutsarang apog.
Correct.
Pero dahil tataas ang pH niya,
correct,
lalaglagan ko siya ng 2 kutsarang suka.
Suka.
Meron bang preference sa sukang paumbong ba?
Whatever, as long as it's
suka. Suka ng tuwa. Masasuka, no? Or isang perasong kalamansi.
Yeah, if you have kalamansi plant,
okay.
Yes.
And then, yung 1 gallon noon, hahaluan ko ng 5 gallong tubig at pwede ko nang spray as foliar sa aking mga tanim. Wow. Okay. So, my dear friends, ito po yung ating lecture ngayon and we would like to thank Rocky French. From here, puntahan natin yung application mismo, yung kanyang garden, kung saan ay ginamit niya yung nitrates sa pagpapataba ng kanyang mga gulay. So, mga kaibigan, ito po yung ating lecture series. And I hope that you learn from this. And we would like to thank Rocky French for his generosity in sharing with us this technology, which can be done by our farmers actually, napakasimple, and which could actually help our farmers in the face of the very high prices of fertilizer in the market right now. Yeah.